Oh god, now I'm going to like lash out and attack. No?
He's tripping or something.
Don't.
Josh!
Okay, man. Just calm down.
Hey, man.
Don't freak the fuck out, buddy. Mental jacket. I like that.
Josh, Hannah was down here for weeks, a month. She dug Beth up. Mike.
Hey, let's just get the fuck out of here.
Okay.
Wow, we might be able to save Josh.
Key for the cable car.
Yeah.
Good, because you may not survive for very long. Stick close, buddy. Don't wander off. Yeah, Mike. Yeah. Your friend is in pretty dire straits right now. Sure, he did some fucked up shit, but
there's no way Josh is gonna make it up there.
Okay. If you help me up, I can go back to the other
side. Or, you know, find a rope or something, maybe?
Yeah, good.
You bring Josh back the way we came and we'll all meet at the lodge.
Oh, great. So, me and Super McFucking Crazy. Oh, I get to control Josh.
Alright, let's go.
While I'm with, well, I'm with old fucking Mikey boy here. Okay. I feel it's probably to my best ability that we stay together.
I'm sorry about before, man. I thought you killed Jess. I was wrong.
Yep. There we go. I knew I'd come over here for something. Oh, look at that. It's a bit of a different bird totem. Come on, give me some good luck. Give me. All right. Fortune. Yeah, Sam is in the cabin, which apparently is going to be burst into flames at some point in the future, according to the other future or fortune totem that we ran across. And now she's going to be in there with a goddamn Wendigo inches from her face. Yeah. These fortune totems are playing out some pretty hefty bullshit right now, if you ask me. For fuck's sake, son. God damn it. Alright, well, now that, you know, you guys have resolved the fact that you didn't murder Jessica, then we can still be buds, right? You know? Fist bump and shit? Oh. Yeah. That's a stranger. Did you know that guy? Yeah, he used to be our groundskeeper. He was a nice dude. Yeah. You're feeling that remorse right now. But just hopefully you don't go erratic from our control. Like, if he just goes on his own fucking whim where it's like, well, I'm going totally crazy now. And I'm going to attack Mike. But now we have to take the long fucking way out of here because, oh, no. No, Mike, you don't. We probably shouldn't. Just because it's, oh, fuck. Yeah. Well, we know that there's a Wendigo in these waters. These waters are unsafe. What do we have waiting for us? Is it QTEs? Is it, oh, Jesus, Mike, where is your shotgun? You didn't leave it behind, did you? Because that would, that'd be a really, really poor mistake if you had left it behind. Just, nope, yeah. Yeah, that one is real. We should probably. Oh, that was that is Hannah. Oh, my. What can I do to convince my sister not to tear me apart? Oh, nope. I guess she's keeping me. Well, that was, well, Mike, it's good that you got away from that. I feel maybe there. I could have done something about that. Matt! Fuck, man, it's been forever. How you doing, buddy? Jesus. Where the fuck did we last leave you off? Are you down in the mines, too? I guess you are, maybe. Uh-huh. And let me just light that up. Why does everybody have a big fucking Zippo lighter with them? Oh, he just picked up. I thought he just picked up a random piece of coal. Yatta! It's the Matt Show. Yes, it's me, I'm Matt. I got a lantern, and there's Wendigos everywhere. But he doesn't know about that, because he hasn't been on the up and up. So, oh, there we go. What do we have here?
What caused that cave-in?
Who knows? Can I move the lantern over to illuminate this a bit better? No? All right, whatever. Let's just back away from the pool of water in which, you know, horrible things can jump out of. So we have established for sure that Hannah is a Wendigo. Wendigo with a pretty little butterfly tattoo. Isn't that nice? She doesn't seem to want to murder Josh. And it seems like she could have tore Mike apart there at that last moment, which, you know, I imagine her feelings that she had for him before are gone because, you know, he's a douchebag and she realizes that now. Come on, let's round this all out with fortune totems, shall we? That is not a fortune totem. All right. That looked like Mike burning to death. Have I already passed that? There have been several situations where Mike has gone into cases where things have been exploding and burning. And yet none of them have got him thus far. So I guess he has one more close call. Maybe, perhaps. I'm thinking that we're getting close since it's, you know, half an hour till dawn. The game has to be coming to a conclusion pretty damn soon, or relatively soon, but, you know, it doesn't mean that we have to let our guard down. That does not state that everybody is not going to be horribly murdered within the next, you know, hour or so. It's hard to tell. That's the most beautiful aspect of this game. Oh, and the music is just ramping up too. That was something that you should not investigate and you should probably get the fuck away from. Run. Yes. Maybe that was a really bad idea because we have no way of defending ourselves. Maybe I should hide. Maybe hiding is an option now? Break through. Break on through to the other side. Yeah, you football son of a bitch. Okay, must move quickly. Must move faster. These things are very maneuverable. Oh, shit. Oh, fuck. Well, so much for that. Fuck. As I said. I don't know how I sifted off to the side. I don't get it. Fuck it. I'm jumping for it. Yeah. There we go. It's faster. It's quicker. And I'm somewhat a bit better at that. Ooh, shit. Oh, fuck. Grab. Damn it! Oh, good landing. Good landing. Okay. Let's go back for it again. Alright. We got triangle. Square. Come on. Fucking Mike just got his face smashed. Or Matt just got his face smashed in. Damn it. Stupid controls. Well, not stupid controls. I should have just... You know, next time that comes up, I can't talk. I can't talk because I just have to move. I have to lock myself into a position and not do anything. Because if I do, even the vibrations in my body will make fucking slip off and someone's going to get their face smashed in. God damn it. Fuck. All right, diverging pathway there. But seems as though... brings me to the same place, or I hope I didn't miss anything on the other route around there. Oh, what do we got here? Wow, these totems are actually getting pretty fancy. That one. Danger totem. They're going to get inside the cabin. I think we've gotten that warning a few times already now. Fucking A. How about the warning of maybe you should learn to hold the damn still a little bit better, which is difficult when you are frightened and you got a little bit of a shake to you, and you have to make sure that the controller doesn't fucking move. I don't think I'm going to make it out here with everybody. I'm gonna put it down on Front Street here. If I make it out of here with more than four people, I did good. And that's starting off with seven, I think. Or eight. If I can hit 50%, 50% is good enough for me, right? Oh, I probably didn't have to take this way, did I? Oh. Oh, this was probably completely and absolutely avoidable. Mm-hmm. Just keep moving, baby. Keep moving. Keep moving. We're doing fine. We're doing just fine. Just need to get out of the water. Don't need any unexpected surprises with that. And watch as this whole thing becomes an unmitigated disaster. But thank God for those yoga pants. Oh, yeah. I love the winding musical cue. You know, the almost kind of constantly building, but not constantly building. I think we're going to be making a headlong sprint back towards the cabin. Is that the light way off in the distance there? Please don't say it is, because we are fucked if that is the case. Oh, no. Okay, cool. Could have gone better. Smooth, very smooth, Sam. I'm sure that if there's judges watching, they would give that a 4.0 out of garbage. Wow, we got a lot closer than I expected. Okay, so we're going to make this run now, hey? Yep, going for it. Yeah, just need to... Okay, jump for the high branch. No. Hiding is something that I don't think I'm very good at. Running seems like the better option. Tried that shit before. Oh, fuck. Damn it. Not very good. Very bad. Very bad. Okay, thank God. It's good that container's there, though. Oh, shit. Was that what killed me? Is that it?
Oh, come on, open up.
Break the glass. Do something. You have... Must do something. Oh, my fucking God.
Oh, gosh.
Yeah, a lot of bad shit has happened.
We stay out here. Come on.
Back to the cabin. All right. Seems like... I thought there was like a fucking key underneath the rock. I'm like, sure, that works out just fine. All right. We just have to last the next 20 minutes until dawn. Well, in-game time, 20 minutes.
Mike, what happened to Josh?
The Wendigo took him.
It got him.
God,
not got him. It just took him. Oh, and that's the thing. No one's going to know that Matt is dead.
Not good.
Well, they hate light, right?
What do you think
that's,
we should do?
We should check the
that's where the others are supposed to be hiding, right?
Okay,
Let's make a beeline for the basement. Actually, can we talk right now? Can we have a real talk right now? Why do I keep catching goddamn items in the foreground or fucking up my depth perception on the things in the background that I'm getting caught up on? It's just, I'm going to stay close to you, and maybe I won't get hung up on the geometry and the environment. And we can get to the basement and progress with the story. Cinematic right now, not good, very bad. Only bad things can happen from here. Ah, the theater. Remember all the good times.
How do you rate our chances of survival?
Hmm? I'm trying not to think about it.
Not...
Oh!
Go,
go, go!
You bitch! You evil, evil bitch! Lock the door, lock the door, lock the door, lock the door.
Shit!
Anyone else have any fucking sense around here? If we can slow the fucking things down, we can at least, you know, find somewhere to go where everybody's just waiting to die. What the fuck? People, we should be running. Oh, shit on me.
Don't.
I can't even talk. Okay. No.
Holy fuck, I can't even breathe. If I breathe, then it moves my legs and my arms are resting on my legs. Do I gotta keep doing this don't move shit? Because I don't think I can hold my breath that long. Oh my god. Is that Hannah? She seems bigger than the rest of them. Wow. Okay. Yeah, gas. Good idea. Use that. That. Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. Everybody, I think we should get the fuck out of here. Seems like a really good idea, right? So I have to make it for the light switch. That's... Ooh, I like your idea. Yeah. Ooh, God. You're gonna give me a fucking prompt that I'm gonna mess up horribly. I just know it. Look at that action. You window goes... Oh, yeah. All right, then. That makes sure you're not getting back up. Can't even breathe. Just need to... Okay. Okay. You have a gun. There's a better way to do this than fucking breaking it with your hand. Just saying. Yeah, Chris, get the fuck out. Oh. No. Save Mike. Go for the switch. Let's just fucking... Oh. He's gonna burn now. Oh, yes. Oh, yes! Thank you, sweet dear. Oh. Okay. Well. Oh, okay. Oops. Oh, shit. Whoa. What the fuck? No, what the hell? How the... three people in one shot? Are you fucking kidding me? Are you fucking kidding? How the fuck? Oh! I could have got out with five! I could have won with. Are you fucking serious? Should I have. I guess I should have waited for everybody else to try to get. I should have tried to. If I tried to save fucking Mike there, I would have died. Sam would have died. And. Are you fucking serious right now? Three?
Fuck.
In a row? Is this my death count? Yeah, where we saw, you know, Beth break her back and die? Ashley, time of death? 6 minutes and 52 seconds until dawn? Fucking bullshit. Hat trick. Yeah, well. Oh. 6:52, so 8 minutes until dawn. Jessica died fucking 12 minutes in. Sorry. Oops. Or no, that would have been midnight. Holy shit. Holy.
The old man,
Wait, what about Josh?
You said you thought he was stalking
us. Oh yeah, we thought the stranger was stalking us.
Did anyone else in your group think that?
Well, probably Mike.
Yeah. Is it possible they could have killed
him? No. No. I saw him get decapitated.
What? No. No, you don't understand. Don't you understand?
If he attacked you...
He saved us. Yeah,
he saved
pretty much.
And I watched him die.
Wow. So they're gonna have... This would have been a lot better with the interviews if I managed to save more people.
Disappear if you can't talk to me. He said I was the only one who understood him. I thought. I thought we had a connection.
I can't.
If you need someone to talk to,
I'm fine.
I wonder
sometimes, after a traumatic experience.
If I save Matt, would it. Oh my god.
It was my fault Mike died. I wasn't supposed to move.
Well, you didn't move, but you We should have decided to save him, I guess.
So it's my fault.
I would think that everyone else would have had the idea to be like, we should GTFO.
You need to listen to me. I don't care if you believe me or not. It doesn't matter because you will. You need to go down to the mines.
Burn those things.
I've seen was
burn
down
everything.
There. And I'd give anything to unsee it.
Bump the controller there. Didn't mean to do that. No, I don't want to skip. Wait, was that the whole credits? Really? Does that mean that they would have given much more time to, you know, everybody else? Yeah, I guess we'd still be hearing interviews right now if I didn't fucking... It couldn't have all come down to that last decision there. There had to have been so many other factors in that. Not the fact that I didn't save Jessica. There had to have been... Well, that might have helped as well, but... I guess I should have kept an eye out for the other kind of prompts that other people were getting the fuck out of there. Not just Chris. Chris had the idea. He's like, there's some really fucked up shit in here. I should, you know, GTFO. And Ashley and Emily not doing anything. They should have fucking followed suit with him very quickly. You know, Mike and Sam being in the forefront and just under the gun there, dealing with fucking Hannah's Wendigo, just tearing apart the under Wendigos. That is like an opportunity to be like, hey, maybe, oh, fuck me. That is, holy shit, especially with a fucking bleak and horrible end. And to fucking think that you can go through the whole game and nobody survives and everybody can survive. I can see how everybody can survive. Do a better fucking job. God damn it. Get a little bit more apt with your QTEs and save fucking Jessica. Hold the hell still. Don't breathe. Just hold your breath and lock your body and don't fucking move. Apparently, though, when this game came out, there was a bit of a bug on that where it was actually substantially harder to hold still, perhaps, or at least that's what I heard. And then they put out like a 10 gigabyte patch about a month later or so, and apparently fixed a lot of those issues. So I have no excuse. I am just fucking hot garbage for murdering all those teenagers. There's probably many, many different opportunities, and there's some, like, a lot of shit that I guess I missed out on, too. Like, I had played past where Jessica died in my game, and then I watched a little bit of the Two Best Friends playthrough, and I think they managed to, or maybe it was a Scary Game Squad with Jesse Cox and Gerard the Completionist and such, and either one of those, I can't remember who, managed to save Jessica. And then I noticed later on, I never watched past beyond whatever I played, so it was all fucking surprises for me. Luckily enough, thank God for that, unlike what I do in my other scary games that I play, where it's just... you know, I watch somebody else's playthrough, so I have a decent idea of how to do it, and then I don't shit the bed and have to replay sections. Until Dawn, it doesn't have that hindrance. This is the best choose-your-own-adventure narrative that continues on no matter how shit you are. I imagine I could have fucked up at a lot of different places, and they probably would have had, you know, kind of outs, like they did with Mike, where I thought I fucked up with him, where it's like, I should have probably shot the barrels between the two Wendigos, and hopefully it would have exploded. But if I didn't shoot, if I didn't shoot that one Wendigo, and then the other one apparently had jumped me, but didn't manage to kill me, and then Sam came and saved me, would have it played out different, or would have there been the situations, like with Mike, if I would have, or not Mike, with Chris, if I would have fucked or shit the bed trying to run away from the Wendigos after the stranger was killed? Or, and there was probably even a few more situations where it's like, hey, you're gonna die. Or, yeah, I guess, yeah, there's decisions that were made where, like, for example, with Matt, when we decided to bash down the door of the chairlift or whatever, and I'm like, that is gonna come back to bite me. I had a fucking overwhelming feeling that would come back to bite me. Or maybe it's just the different social interactions. The fact that with Ashley, I kind of... Or I don't know if it was my decision-making on that, where it's like... Or no, I think I was still playing Mike, but due to information and such, Ashley's like, Emily, you're bit. You're going to turn into one of them. You should fucking kill her. And then I guess maybe if I didn't delve deeper into the information that the bites don't change you, it's only cannibalism that turn you into a Wendigo. Oh, Japanese voice cast. Fuck, that'd be pretty interesting to hear that. You know, saw a little bit of that social link failure as they're running away from the Wendigos out of the basement of the house, and fucking Emily just pushes Ashley out of the way, and almost, you know, who knows what other things could have occurred that would have caused a lack of social link between the characters. Maybe I'm just looking too deep into it. Maybe I'm reading much further into the dynamics in the game, like the all the aspects behind the game than what are really there. But oh yes, stinger. Oh shit, and this is that totem I saw of old Josh turning into a Wendigo. Who was he eating? Is he eating Peter Stormare? I think he's eating Peter.
I have a visual on a survivor. One survivor, repeat. Is that?
Oh, fuck.
Stay back, no.
Mini butterfly effect updated. What the fuck does a post-credit scene have to do with what the fuck happened? Are you fucking crazy? Okay. Alright. Delving down into this now with the stats. Let's see the decisions we did. Any of your business. Sam respected Chris's privacy. Chris was happy to see that. Okay. Chris continued to trust Sam. Come on. Oh, so because of that, we managed to retain his trust. Chris chose not to shoot the squirrel. Nature remained in balance. And that's the thing, too, is not fucking with nature. I think that was a really big aspect for that. Ashley discouraged Matt from using the telescope. Matt didn't see Mike and Emily flirting. Matt was relaxed when Mike and Jessica arrived at the lodge. Emily and Jessica fought. And that was the end of that. Man, I barely remember Jessica. Matt sided with Jessica during the fight with Emily. Emily was aggressive with Matt. And it just ends there. So she wouldn't have been such a fucking cold-hearted bitch if I had taken her side. Mike came to Jessica's aid immediately. Jessica appreciated Mike's heroism. Mike continued to impress Jessica. That's why Jessica got down to her panties. Jessica was a pushover. Managed to woo her in the most spectacular manner. Sam found a baseball bat and left it in the cellar. Sam had the option to use the bat when being chased. Unfortunately, you suck at QTEs. You missed a chance to use it. Mike stumbled when chasing after Jessica. Mike was too late. Jessica was dead. Matt was all alone in the mine. Oh, so if Jessica was with us, if she survived, well, she would have been, left in the mine and everything like that, then Matt would have ran into her, and that would have changed shit. Chris said that he would save Josh, but then didn't. Josh was sympathetic to Chris and antagonistic to Mike. Oh, okay. So that decision does have weight when you choose who to kill and who's to survive, although Josh gets cut in half anyways because it's a work, it's a fix. Mike hacked off his own fingers. Mike still had a usable machete. And I wonder if that made... Yeah, Sam rescued Mike from the sanatorium. Because I had the usable machete in that situation where the Wendigo was coming through the window, I remembered I had the machete. Did that make all the difference there? Could Mike have died at that moment? Mike didn't kick the wolf. Mike made a friend. The wolf guided Mike around the sanatorium, which, you know, was completely linear and didn't really need it anyways, but Mike's new friend survived. So the wolf could have been murdered horribly too. So that's even a character... Hey, that's three. If we get one more ancillary fucking bullshit character, I'll hit my 4, which is not out of the 50% because that changes the numbers entirely. Matt supported Emily's plan to go to the tower and get help. Matt fired the flare to signal for help. Okay. Cool. Sam got herself caught. Chris and Ashley found Sam. Sam needed to be rescued by Mike. And yeah, you can... completely get away from that encounter and wouldn't need rescuing, but how does that change a lot of shit? Mike walked calmly through the herd. Matt and Emily escaped the threat unscathed. So, if I decide to attack those elk or whatever, then we would got our asses kicked there too, maybe? Emily gave the flare gun to Matt. Emily has no defense against the attack and was bitten. Oh, Mike faced a dilemma. So if I had the flare gun, then I wouldn't have gotten bitten. And then I wouldn't have been accused of being, or she wouldn't have been accused of being able to turn into a Wendigo. Matt jumped to safety. Matt was still alive. He could have fucking died there, but was killed trying to escape. Nice photo, guys. Great. Thanks. Ashley took the scissors. Ashley stabbed the psycho. The psycho gave Ashley a black eye. Chris hit Josh because of that. Interesting how that blends in together. Ashley followed Chris. Ashley followed to see who was in the workshop. Chris and Ashley found a dummy in Sam's clothes. Oh, I didn't even realize that those were Sam's clothes. Huh. Chris didn't shoot Ashley. Ashley was concerned about Chris as he left. Ashley opened a door, saving Chris's life. So he could have fucking died there. Oh my God. Emily was bitten. Mike spared Emily. Ashley was faced with a dilemma and told the truth. Emily pushed past Ashley and Ashley was killed. Really? So if I would have lied about that and not revealed that information, then, yeah, as I was mentioning, Emily wouldn't have been super pissed and there's... Oh my God. Ashley wouldn't leave Chris. Ashley followed the voice. Ashley joined the others. So Chris was safe. So would have that put Chris into danger if I would have opened that thing and not fucked up and ignored it? Sam found Hannah's journal in the mine. Josh heard the truth about the monster. Josh recognized Hannah and Hannah recognized Josh. Josh was alive, trapped and cannibalistic. So Josh survived. That's four, if I include the goddamn dog. Sam escaped. Mike died in the lodge. Ashley died in the lodge. Emily died in the lodge. Chris escaped. And yeah, we know that Matt died horribly and Jessica died horribly too. Jesus Christ. There you go. That, I found most of the mysteries. I only missed two totems. Fuck. Not bad for a lot of dicking around and looking at shit that didn't really matter. It appears I only missed two of the clues about the twins. Missed only two things about the sanatorium. And I missed a ton of shit about the fucking mystery man. Alright. I kind of shit the bed on that, but goddamn. Well, there you have it. There you are. There you go. That is the first and probably only time that Garrett will finish a spooky game. And as always, take her easy.